Welcome to Film Dudes, a place where we're talking about all the movie news and movie goodness. I'm Sean. Unfortunately, Morgan is not with us today, but the show must go on. So, without further ado, let's start the show off with a little bit of This Week in Theaters. And this week in theaters, we have Entourage, Spy, and Insidious Chapter 3. Now, as we all know, Entourage was a show on HBO for many of years, but I've never seen it. But I do know that it is roughly based on Mark Wahlberg's life, I think. It might just be the movie, I honestly don't know. Anyway, Entourage the movie doesn't look that funny to me. It might have its good parts, but it honestly doesn't look that great. So I'm gonna have to pass. And with it having a 30% on Rotten Tomatoes, critics aren't giving it that much credit either. On the bright side, it does have an 83% audience score. So there's hope for that. So if you wanna go see it, you might like it. Apparently the audience loves it, but critics aren't too fond of it. Also coming out this week in theaters is Spy. And honestly, I had no hope for Spy because Melissa McCarthy hasn't made a good movie since Bridesmaids. I mean, come on, Tammy? Really? You can't play the same character in every single one of your movies. Eddie Murphy did it. Jim Carrey did it. Adam Sandler did it. No. Don't do it. I honestly expected this movie to be an average comedy with a poor storyline, but critics are going crazy about this movie. This movie is a 95% on Rotten Tomatoes. I might actually have to go see this movie in theaters. No, I'm not gonna go see a Melissa McCarthy movie, but Spy is on my list to go see because it has a 95% on Rotten Tomatoes, and that is crazy to me. A comedy that has a 95% on Rotten Tomatoes is unbelievable. What movie is gonna have a 95% with Jason Statham in it? Let's be honest with that. Dead Race? Maybe in this movie she's playing a different role than she has in previous movies. Who knows? But in any case, it is still Melissa McCarthy, and I'm still kind of sketchy about it, but I might go see it. If you guys want to go see it, go right ahead, because it does have a 95% on Rotten Tomatoes, and that's pretty good for a comedy. And lastly, Insidious Chapter 3 has finally arrived. Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys. The only good thing about this Insidious franchise is the first film. Now, the second film wasn't awful, but it wasn't great. And with the third film not being directed or written by James Wan, I'm gonna have to pass. And it doesn't look that great to begin with. I don't know, Insidious Chapter 3, it could be good. Critics aren't really liking it too much because it's not that great on Rotten Tomatoes. But, I mean, it's a horror film. People go see horror films, and that's just how it is. Now last week we talked about Doctor Strange and how they added more cast members to the film. But this week, Guardians of the Galaxy 2 is officially done! Well, the script at least. The script is done. The actual film, that won't be done for a while. But the script is done. Director of the film, James Gunn, has finally finished the first draft. And it brought Chris Pratt to tears. Now honestly, a script that brings you to tears, that's crazy. James Gunn went live on Periscope to reveal small details about the script. Gunn stated that Guardians 2 will have less major characters because he feels that today's superhero movies are getting too sprawling and too crazy. Finally, someone said it. Avengers already had a boatload of characters, and then in Avengers 2, they introduced even more characters. It's so hard to keep track and so much is going on. I can't understand. I didn't even like the second film. Let's be honest, I didn't. It was an average film. I'm sorry. Also, he pointed out the Guardians franchise will introduce new characters, but will focus on developing the existing characters on a more emotional level. And James Gunn had to cut a major character from Guardians 2 because the script was too busy. But he hopes that he'll be able to use the character in the future. But who could that character be? Now, Gunn previously stated that Guardians 2 will feature a new Guardian, who could possibly be his favorite superhero. But could this be the character that he wrote of the script? But whoever this individual was, he or she was not important enough to keep in the script, so everything is a-okay. I mean, come on, the script brought Chris Pratt to tears. Guardians of the Galaxy 2 will be released August 2016. Alright, so let's go back a year. Guillermo del Toro said Hellboy will never happen, and we started to expect that. But Ron Perlman, who played Hellboy, took his thoughts to the internet this week. Perlman tweeted on Twitter, "Anyone out there want to see Hellboy 3 as much as I do? Let's get this mofo trending, y'all. Let's end the trilogy. We earned it." And soon after, Doug Jones, who played Abe Sapien in the films, banned with Perlman, stating, "Locking elbows with you, Big Brother Red." Now, it's not because Del Toro doesn't want to make the film. It's because the studio won't finance the film, and it's now the internet's time to make it happen. Now, this isn't the first time the internet has made a movie happen. Recently, Fox turned down Tim Miller and Ryan Reynolds funding for Deadpool. But when test footage of Deadpool leaked, it went viral. And now Deadpool just wrapped up principal photography. So if anything that can make Hellboy 3 happen, it's the internet. Honestly, I would love to see this movie made. I love the first two movies. I wish they would make a third one. I've been waiting for it for so long. Please, internet, make this happen, because Hellboy 3 would be a great movie, and Guillermo del Toro is a great director. Anyway, guys, our next topic is Suicide Squad. Now, Scott Eastwood is afraid of Jared Leto on the Suicide Squad set. Kind of weird. Now, as we all know, Jared Leto gets really into his roles, but has he gone too far? Eastwood has been speaking of him as if the Joker and Leto are two different people, stating that he has met Leto before, but he does not recognize him on the set of Suicide Squad. Now, when I heard Jared Leto was going to play the Joker in Suicide Squad, I knew he was going to do a great job because of the way he portrays his characters. He's a method actor. He acts the part until the movie is finished. He goes to great lengths to make this character believable, and it's amazing to see an actor go from character to character and transform themselves into the character and just believe that they are actually this person. And I commend Jared Leto for doing that. But anyways, Eastwood talks of Leto in the past tense, so maybe his issue of approaching Leto on set has passed and everything is all good. But anyways, guys, that is it. That's another show in the wraps. If you would like to read more about what we discussed today, all the links are in the description below. But with the end of the episode, that brings up the question of the day. And the question of the day is, do you think Suicide Squad will be a great movie? Are you excited for Suicide Squad? Do you think Jared Leto will be better than Jack Nicholson as a Joker, or even better than the great Heath Ledger? Go ahead and leave your answers down in the comment section below. But anyways, guys, if you like this episode, be sure to thumbs it up and share it to your friends so they can learn some movie news and movie goodness. I'm Sean. Morgan will hopefully be back with me next week. But until then, watch some movies.